Okay, in the second part of this meeting on reverb, we're going to find out how we can abuse the reverb. So to use it in a way which is not really a normal way to use it. We're going to use it in a way to do some sound design. And how are we going to do it? We're going to make use of feedback. I've been creative. So, what is feedback? If you are on a stage and you're a singer and you're singing in a live situation, you also want to hear your voice. And for that, the audio engineer will put a monitor speaker below next to your feet, and it's faced upwards, and it will play the sound of the band and the sound of your voice while you're singing, so you can hear your own voice in relation to the band. The thing is, when this speaker is a little bit too loud, it will lead to feedback. How does it work? So you're singing and your vocal is recorded by the microphone, it's read, and then it's being sent through the cable to the speaker, and the speaker, well, is meant to be aimed at your ears so that you can hear yourself, but the sound is also going back again to the microphone. So sound that is being recorded here at the same time gets sent back to the same microphone, and it's being recorded again, sent back again, record it again, and in that way it starts to get louder and louder and louder and louder and louder, and if it starts to be really loud, you start to hear like a very high beep. So to prevent that, they turn the volume of the speaker a little bit down so that you don't get feedback, or you don't point your microphone at the speaker, which is not a smart thing to do. But that's exactly what we are going to do now. So we're going to use the reverb. The first part, we talked about the reverb, how you can use it, and we will be also using it the coming weeks during the mixing. But now we're going to abuse it to kind of emulate this situation. So we're going to build feedback in Ableton as a tool to do some sound design. Yeah. So what does it consist of? It consists of a speaker that's playing the sounds, then the sound travels through the air, so through space. So we will be emulating that with our reverb. It's being recorded by the microphone, and the right microphone will make it a little bit louder, send it back to the speaker, and the speaker is playing it again, going again through space, which is emulated by the reverb, being recorded again, etc., etc., etc. So we're going to build this feedback loop, yeah, this closed circle. And to get the sound going, you need an initial sound, because if there's nothing to be amplified, you won't be sending anything through space, you won't be recording anything, there's nothing that can start the feedback. So you need also a sound to start. So now we move to Ableton. So first let's get a sound to start. Let's make it just a little noise. Yeah, okay. So to send stuff around in Ableton, we are using the so-called sends. So this is the send. With this, I can send this sound to somewhere else. So if I send it to A, it will come out here under A. You see, it starts to, if it's closed, you don't hear it. And now it starts to come out here as well. So here we're going to emulate this feedback loop. So let's say it's coming out there. So this is our speaker. We can hear it through the speaker, and the speaker makes a sound, and that's what we're going to send around. The first thing that you have to do, that's the most important one even of today, is you have to put a limiter on the master. Don't forget it. Check if it's there and put the ceiling around minus 10. Yeah? Don't forget this is really important. Why? Because this situation actually in the audio world is a little bit dangerous because the sound gets in, it gets louder and louder and louder. And if you don't stop this process, it will go on and on and on. And there's a big chance that you're listening to this with headphones on. So it can really be bad for your ears. So in case this process will get out of hand, put a limiter on your master and put the ceiling so it cannot go louder than the ceiling at minus 10. Yeah, that's the first step. Okay, so back to here. We have the speaker, and then we on the other hand we have the we're going to mimic the microphone. And we're going to send this stuff around, just like here. The microphone is being sent to the speaker, and the speaker will be sent to the microphone, but going through the air. So the microphone is sent to the speaker. The microphone is sent to the speaker. So this one needs to go to A. This one is not working now because Ableton wants to prevent feedbacking. So we have to enable it, kind of hacking it. So now this stuff from the microphone gets sent to the speaker, and the speaker, we're going to send it to the microphone. But first, let's emulate this yellow arrow, which is the room. It's not, the microphone is not being put close to the to the speaker. It's like on a distance. There's a distance, so sound has to move through air. Yeah, so we have to build this space between it. Well, we talked about reverb. Reverb is the emulation of space. So now we're just going to put it between the speaker and the microphone. Don't forget to put this on 100%, because otherwise you're kind of saying now like, okay, 60% is just moving with the speed of light. Actually, that's not possible. Set everything through the space, yeah? And it will take some time, you know? Sound travels through space with a certain speed. So let's put this at, for example, 30 milliseconds. Let's say. So, oh, sorry, that's my phone. So now the sound comes out of the speaker and moves through space for 30 milliseconds, and then it's being sent to the microphone. So enable it and then send it to the microphone. Don't turn this up in one time, because actually this is the amplification. So if you turn this up and this up in one time, you this whole process might explode. You have to do it carefully. And another thing that you should not forget, and I almost forgot it now, so please follow these steps carefully, because you have to be careful with your ears. You have to use a compressor. So what's the compressor doing? It's watching at this, it's looking at this process, and it's getting louder and louder. And if it gets too loud, we talked about compression, then the compressor can make it softer. So the compressor, you can say like, if it's getting louder than this, make it softer. How much? Well, do it a lot, because it's like a strong process. So make it like 10 times as soft. Switch this off. Yeah, switch it, please switch it off. Yeah. So now we have the microphone, we have the sound. The sound is being sent to the speaker. The speaker is playing it. It's going through the air to the microphone. Here, to the microphone. The microphone records it and sends it back to the speaker. Yeah. So now we're going to set to switch the feedback process on. So if you what I said, like if you're in a live situation, you don't want the speaker to be too loud, because then you get feedback, but we do want feedback. So we're going to make it louder and just check how it sounds. Yeah, you hear a little bit of feedback, and now we can make it a little bit louder here. And now it comes slowly alive. And if you make it softer again, it stops. Yeah? So let's make it louder. And now the assignment for today is that you create an audio track here and you set this the audio from. You see, if you click on the IO, this thing pops up. So IO, audio from, you do resampling and you just start recording while you start to play with this feedback patch. And I will just show you a little bit what you can do. So let's record. So you see it's recording. Now let's switch on this process. And then I'm going to tweak the reverb a little bit. Just check out the sounds. They totally move on their own, that's really nice. You can put some extra effects here, and this is really up to you for your taste to check it out. Put some effects in between. Yes. Okay, and then you have a recording. And please post it to the SoundCloud. The only thing is the SoundCloud might fill up a little bit. Everybody starts to post sessions of half an hour tripping sound. So maybe, you know, with this, choose a part that you really like and upload like 1 minute or something like that to the course folder. And that's the assignment for today. So have fun. If there are any questions, post them below the video and I will answer to it. All right. Thank you.